hi! Didn't see you there. Welcome to my humble home. Oh, you don't know who I am? Well, I am sure you are familiar with the National Kidney Foundation. In 1992, I became the acting CEO, and we have been achieving breakthroughs ever since. In 1994, we started the telepole fundraising. By getting people to perform stunts, we earned 3.9 million in donations that year. Subsequently, we have provided more covered subsidies, newer medical treatment, and better facilities for our patients. Because of the growing company, we opened a new headquarters in 1995. Throughout the years, the number of our patients has been growing steadily, and so our bills are getting more expensive. But with your continuous help, we will be able to fund our centers. We received 11 million in 2001, 15 million in 2003, and 14 million in 2004. How can I help you?
Help me, please! Please help me! My son needs the dialysis, please!
I'm very sick. Oh, brother.
Why am I not getting the subsidies for dialysis? Don't you have enough funds from the donation?
Can my mom go for the dialysis, please? We don't have any money, but please. She needs the dialysis.
Are they really that low on cash?
In actual fact, the NKF receives 10 to 20 calls each day, questioning their reliability. Letters of defamation, too, are being circulated around constantly.
With an annual turnover of about $100 million, where is the money going to?
Furthermore, out of the 3,000 that NKF claimed to be helping, they were actually treating 1,000 less. In 1998 and 1999, there have been accusations of Durai taking first-class flights to meetings overseas. Madam Tan sent an email from her company, which states that untrue? No one was sure at that time. Either way, Madam Tan was sued. But later on in April 2004, NKF was accused of installing golden taps, pricey German basins, and glass shower panels. Who accused them? Singapore Press Holdings. This then led to a lawsuit with NKF demanding an apology. However, the case was dropped by Durai after his annual salary was disclosed. Later on, it was revealed that Durai had access to not one, not two, not three, not four. You think it's five? Nope. Six? Nuh-uh. Seven? Get out of town. It was a grand whooping total of eight. Chauffeured cars. Even the upkeeping for his own Mercedes-Benz was paid by the NKF. Since when did Durai have such privileges for being a member of NKF? And just what were so many chauffeured cars for? Is NKF now a game show or something?
Congratulations, you won!
Mrs. Go-Chop Tong states otherwise.
All NKF asked for was a retraction. Instead, they have expanded the case into other matters. I have complete faith in the NKF and Mr. Durai.
When she also said,
for a person who runs a big million-dollar charitable organization, $600,000 a year is peanuts.
Many wondered what was going through Mrs. Go's mind. What the f-? Eventually, Durai was sentenced to a jail term and fined $12 million. Still, no one knows when the money scandal actually started and what is fair punishment for him.
Whoa! Now don't make me wait too long, too long. Oh, oh, oh. Now don't.